Hello everybody, this is AOG Gaming here, back with another video on Balloons Tower Defense 6. I was trying to post this video last night, but I don't know why, I couldn't get my strategy down. It wasn't working the way I wanted it to. So downstream Black Border, let's just get into it. I was trying so hard to post it yesterday, but I didn't have enough time. There's so much stuff I had planned. Alright, so this is a pretty easy. You just place SADA down here. She can take care of many things. But I don't know. This map seemed easy, but then when I tried the strategy that I used the gold border, excuse me, it worked much better than I thought it would, but we're gonna try anyway. Okay, so you put the sub as far back as you want, put it as strong, and then this can pretty much defend early game. We're still gonna get more towers, obviously. But yeah, still using the glue gunner and the ice. Very sad. You're going to clear this so that you can put your towers down in that little loop right there. I'm going to move my phone real quick. So I don't know why, but it just didn't work. And I was able to get a gold border with it only because I had to go back home. Maybe that's what happened. Does it reset your abilities when you go home? I don't think so. But if it does, let me know. Obviously, we're going for a Ring of Fire. I don't really need to explain that. It deals with all the ceramics. Has decent mob damage. Especially when you're gluing down these towers. But yes. Okay, even faster shooting. Even more attacks. So I'm wondering if I can get a village and put it down here. See if that would work. Because honestly, that would be amazing. Yeah, we will see. But let me get hotshots real quick. Deal extra damage. And now we can go for longer range, advanced intel, barbed darts. And then this is your first mob popping tower. So do keep that in mind. Advanced intel, now it can hit basically everywhere. Everywhere within the range of these existing towers. But it'll be able to hit around the loop. Don't worry about that. Then we get heat-tip darts. You need that for the leads. Well, you don't really need it because you have this, but just because it also helps with camos when they get in range of SADA, so should be golden there. And actually, you can get the village before round 30, and still get Ring of Fire and Moab Glue, surprisingly. So put this like here, if it lets me. Okay, cool. SADA is not within range right now, but you will be, don't worry. Let me get larger range. And I want to see if I can put the boat right next to the sub. And it still will have that village. Oh, yes, perfect. Okay, cool. Okay, that's perfect. Alright, and then now we save up for Ring of Fire and Glue Gunner. Wait a little bit though, because you don't really need camo right now, and you do want to save up for this Ring of Fire. Oh, we also do need the Ballistic Missile. Okay. Just wait a little bit. Save up some money. Honestly, you don't need the Moab glue, but you can use the Moab glue. Okay, we're very close to this ring of fire here. Oh, we should get it this round, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, perfect. Ring of fire deals with everything that's not a ceramic. And we should be able to get this ballistic missile now. And it's still on strong. Okay, cool. We are gonna get grape shot and hot shot, and then we'll get faster firing. Honestly, it's fine. You don't need the Moab glue until later. Let me get double shot. Okay, cool. We're still gonna get down our glue gunner, but right, does it reach over here? Oh, it does. Okay, cool. But we're putting our glue gunner here. As far as we can. And obviously we're going down middle path, cross path. Just because it's so much stronger. Okay, so you just gotta time it. And well, it pretty much takes care of everything, so it doesn't really matter, but just in case, we go for radar scanner now. It can deal with rainbows. You can deal with camo rainbows with this strategy because the sub and SATA, but you don't want to risk it. So just get the camo village when you can. Okay, now we get jungle drums. Now everything should be attacking faster. Perfect. And now we're going to actually rush for, not rush, but get our primary mentoring. And then after that, we can finish upgrading our glue gunner and our ice. Maybe we should have waited for the glue gunner, but it's not a very big deal. I don't think so. And then this will also get insane range, extra damage. Pierce, same with this. And now we just save up for the Moab glue, and we're good for now. And then we can get Destroyer when we need it, obviously. Okay, now we get Moab glue. It's a little bit different than what I wanted, but it should work. I tried to use fifth tier bottom path glue, fifth tier icicle impale bottom path ice, and fifth tier top path monkey ace sky shredder. Didn't work the way I wanted it to, so I guess we're going with this strategy since it's a tried and true strategy. Okay, Destroyer. So yeah, it basically aircraft carrier plus relent super glue. Sorry, not relentless glue. Yeah, and it should be able to take care of everything. But we will see. Because this is my first time actually using this in the strategy, but it should work because I've used it before in just the primary strategy. And it did work, so. Right now, this is doing all the mob damage, but we'll get enough mob damage once we upgrade this. Like I said, though, this has basically range all the way to the end of this. Of this guy's radius and around the loop, so we're completely fine. Okay, so now we have enough Moab damage, and technically we also have enough ceramic popping. This slows everything down, and then this will completely demolish it, but it's fine, we'll just wait. And right now we're doing very good. I mean, this is a very strong tower just in general. And of course, we're going to be spamming. Well, if we can get the Sky Shredder, then we'll get the Sky Shredder. But if we can't, then we'll just be spamming our Operation Dot Storms, ODSs. Right now, we're saving up for super glue because it is very broken. The regrow only is blocked here. It's going to be interesting because I had the village in the loop before, so it could block all the regrow in the loop. So I don't know how this will work, but it should be fine. Excuse me. Yeah, we only need 17 more K. It's pretty much the same with other strategies. 63 doesn't matter. I don't think I have to mention that, but just in case. Yeah, the glue gunner stun is just ridiculous. And with the Moab glue stun, it's also ridiculous. We do have to get super glue for that. It also does damage over time, if I did not mention that. So, satisfying the three categories for Sada. Stun, slow, and dealing damage over time. That is specifically for level 11. Immobilized or taking damage over time from other monkeys. So it's taking damage over time. Technically, it's immobilized, but also, like I said before, 7 doing extra damage if they are stunned. So I don't know if that stacks or if immobilized has to be frozen. But if it does stack with that, then perfect, because this satisfies four criteria then. But if not, then it satisfies three, which is good enough. But if it does all four of them, then, well, it doesn't do all four of them because it's not frozen. But technically, it's immobilized, stunned, taking damage over time. Yeah, I think that's. Is there four criteria? I'm so confused. Okay, so doing extra damage if they are stunned. Okay, yeah, slowed. Sorry. Okay, so slowed, immobilized, stunned, and taking damage over time. Technically, this does do all four, but I don't know if stun counts as immobilized. I'm pretty sure it should because it technically is stopping the balloon for a certain amount of time. And if that is true, then this will be dealing a lot more damage. Okay. Should we just go for. No, because we do need the Moab glue. And also, we can save up 27k pretty easily. It's also the fact that this does really decent damage just overall, even without all the Moab missiles. Like the planes plus the main attack, it just deals a lot more damage. Okay, super glue now. Let's just have to wait for this to pop and super glue. And there you see the Moab stun is ridiculous. Okay, so I'm pretty sure we can set this on strong. Ceramics don't really matter until pass around 80. Doing good so far. We should be able to get carrier flagship pretty easily. Not before round 80, I don't think so. And I guess we'll get down some alchemists when we need to. For now, we're good. We have all the Moab power we need, and ceramics aren't a problem until after round 80. Of course, you know, super ceramics. Really annoying. They just have double health, but don't spawn double amount of balloons. So it's like twice as hard with half the money. Which is really brutal, but it is how the ramp up works. So far, just annihilating these balloons. Yeah, there's not really any problems, but it gets a little bit sketchy as you saw right there. So just have your finger over Sada's abilities just in case. You don't really need to use them, I'm pretty sure, but just in case. Yeah, I don't think Sada's going to be dealing a lot of damage this game because the balloons aren't right next to her, but when they are, she'll be dealing insane damage. That was the wrong time to use that. Okay. Oh, it's round 78. Never mind. Well, there's Camel Ceramics, right? At the end of this round? Okay, well, I reloaded the ability anyway, but I mean, we were fine, but just in case, you know, use it. When there's a lot of ceramic rushes like that, you just want to use it. Oh my god. Something is just like stuck in my throat and I can't get it out. I didn't drink a lot of water today and I did wake up like an hour ago, so maybe that's why. Yeah, and then spaced Moabs don't really do anything. They're kind of just extra money for us. Even fortified because, again, they're being completely immobilized by this glue gunner. And he is dealing damage over time. It's pretty decent, too. It does matter. Not as much as you think, but it still matters more than you think. See what I did there? Round 80 is completely fine. ZOMGs don't really do anything. They're so slow that even without the stun, they're just basically infinitely slowed. The slow is just ridiculous with Superb Glue. Super Glue. They changed the name. Sorry. It used to be Superb Glue. But now it's just Super Glue. Okay. One more. $1,000 more. And we will be there. Carrier flagship. And destruction. The does extra damage clause of this upgrade. So useful. Sure, the extra damage on the Moab missiles and also the planes that can do a lot more damage. Very good, but just in general, the fact that it does extra damage is ridiculous. Also, I forgot to mention, it is damage over time fire, so I don't know if the damage over time stacks. Like, she does extra damage per different type of dots on the tower, but if it does, then that's great. That's all we need. And now we can actually get our Ace Monkey. I'm actually going to put him, like, here. Because I am going to get centered path anyway. And there's our first ODS. A lot of damage. And we should be good for now. We actually are saving up quite a bit of money, so we can maybe go for this Sky Shredder pretty early. Which will be fantastic, but let's not get our hopes up. Yeah, and then this stun is just ridiculous. Yeah, this glue gunner, the fifth tier, the new update that they redid, gold. For any Sada strategy, just gold. Just because of how strong it is. And also the fact that, like I said before, it satisfies at least 3, if not 4, depending on how Ninja Kiwi decided how that wording works. If it does satisfy 4, then that's perfect. You don't need any other tower, really. Well, I mean, you don't need any other tower to satisfy the criteria for Sada doing extra damage, but, you know, it's always good to have extra just in case.
We do have 20k right now, which is a lot of money. So we will see, but we have enough mob damage. We're pretty much destroying, yeah, even fortified. And once they get within range of this glue gunner, they're destroyed. I mean, this is dealing enough damage, this is dealing more damage. And we're slowly getting enough money. We need 20 more K, so that's perfect. So here comes some DDTs, but they don't matter at all. I mean, when you have enough mob damage, they don't matter. Okay, let's hope we can defend all of this. I'm pretty sure we can, but just in case. Okay, yeah, that was not as hard as I thought it would be. Come on, we make a lot of money on this round. Or a decent amount of money. I would say not a lot, but a decent. We are at 30k. I might want to get Icicle Impale, but at the same time, I don't know. We just need 14 more K, and we have the Sky Shredder, which is going to be insanely strong. So I don't know, but we're going to wait a little bit. If we need to, I'll slow down, get the Ice Monkey, and call it a day. Once again, DDT is not a problem. Round 95 might be a slight issue. That's why I'm contemplating whether I should get this Ice Monkey or not. We're still 10k away. And round 94 is known to be a little bit dense with a lot of ZOMGs. Let's hope we can get just demolish these. Oh, we're doing pretty good. Now it's just down to the ZOMGs, and Sada's going to be dealing a ridiculous amount of damage. I mean, the super ceramics are really all I'm worried about, because there is a lot of ceramics. Okay, we dealt with those balloons. Just gonna use this real quick. Okay, put this on first, because those DDTs are going to be technically first. We just need $2,000 more, and we should be able to deal with everything. Okay, now we just need $1,000. Slow down real quick. I don't want to, like... Yeah, there's a lot of mobs. That's my issue with this. Oh, come on. Let me get Sky Shredder. Sky Shredder. Oh my goodness. Okay, Sky Shredder. Make sure you get it right when I got it, just in case. We're going to put this here. Now, we kind of just need more popping damage. So, get down some alchemists. Oh, come on. There's a spot right here. Right now, I'm only getting 4th tier, but... Oh, my goodness. Yeah, this is just demolishing these balloons. Okay, stronger stimulant. Okay, that was a good call going with the Sky Shredder, because it all will also do most of the bad damage that we do need. However, round 98 is coming, so... Just keep that in mind. Round 98 is always insanely hard. Though we are, like, demolishing everything, so... Okay, yeah, now it's just BFBs and mobs, which... Okay, Yusada's ability there, just because you might need it. And now we can probably go for another one of these. Yeah, the DDTs don't really matter. And now you just need the mob damage. You should have enough mob damage, though. This is dealing mob damage. This is dealing mob damage. This, and this. Let's hope we can pop it, please. Okay, yeah. And there you go. Black border downstream. Okay, let's just go home and make sure that we get it so there's no if, buts, and whatever's about it. There you go. Downstream black border. Apologize for not uploading it last night. I did promise. There was just a lot of stuff. But here it is. Uploading it now this morning. Yeah, if you guys are enjoying the content, please like and subscribe. It really shows your support. Helps me out. Keeps you up to date with my content. 31 subscribers and going strong. You guys are amazing. Keep going. Firing range. I'm kind of dreading that one. I don't know how long that's going to take me. Cracked and stream bed are going to be easy, but yeah, downstream was easy as well. Firing reach. I don't know what I'm going to do for that one, but we'll figure it out. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. We are getting very close to finishing intermediate maps. We have 6 more maps to finish in intermediate. Then we move to advanced, which I am 100% dreading. Because this is where the maps get ridiculous. I don't even have to explain. You can just look at the maps, but they get ridiculous. And I know there's specific chimp strategies for them, but yeah. The good thing is that there's only... Wait. So... 12, 13, 14 maps in advanced. Whereas intermediate, we had 6, 12, 18, 19. And then beginner has 6, 12, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 maps. So advanced has a lot less. Only 14, and then expert, of course, only has, oh wow, 11. So it'll be a less of an endeavor, but the amount of time I'm going to be spending on each map is going to be a lot. So just be prepared. Well, I mean, it'll probably be the same amount of uploads, but yeah, we're slowly getting to the end, guys. So I really appreciate everyone who's been on this journey with me. But yeah, we're completing every single black border. Yeah, that's all I have for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys later.